A deficiency of vitamin B12 is a serious health issue that is often overlooked, even by doctors. This is because the effects of a vitamin B12 deficiency can appear even when its concentration in the blood is within the normal range. This may seem unbelievable, but this is what happens in reality. That is why I believe that the current norms for vitamin B12 are too low. In this video, I will not only talk about the symptoms of vitamin B12 deficiency, but also who is at risk and how to effectively replenish our bodies with this vitamin. You will also learn from this material that measuring vitamin B12 in the blood may not be enough to determine its actual level in the body. I will start by presenting the symptoms that can appear in a situation where there is a lack of vitamin B12 in our body. Generally, when most people talk about a deficiency of vitamin B12, they mean anemia. Indeed, one of the consequences of a deficiency of B12 is the development of anemia, specifically so-called megaloblastic anemia. Before I list the signs associated with anemia due to a deficiency of B12, I have to mention that a lack of the aforementioned vitamin B12 causes much greater damage in our body. That is why, in terms of health consequences, I consider a deficiency of vitamin B12 to be a much more serious problem than, for example, a deficiency of iron, which also leads to anemia. Let's focus first on anemia. When we lack vitamin B12, red blood cell production is impaired, namely erythrocytes. Specifically, they are characterized by a damaged structure and an abnormal appearance, meaning they are unnaturally large in size. This is where the term megaloblastic anemia comes from. These damaged red blood cells also have a shorter lifespan and reduced ability to perform their functions, which triggers a cascade of ailments. For example, people with B12 deficiency complain of chronic fatigue and constant weakness, even when performing basic daily activities such as shopping, cleaning, or even walking the dog. Generally, people with B12 deficiency lack vitality and often feel tired, but rest, including sleep, is unable to fully regenerate the body. Additionally, in the course of B12 deficiency, there may be shortness of breath during physical exertion, which is related to insufficient oxygenation of the body. Signs of a B12 deficiency similar to an iron deficiency include a pale skin tone with a yellow lemon hue. Our skin loses its rosy color, becoming brighter. We can usually notice this transformation on the inside of the mouth, on our lips, and around our eyes. As an interesting fact, with a B12 deficiency, premature graying of hair can also occur. People with a B12 deficient body may also suffer headaches caused by hypoxia of the brain, among other things. As for the symptoms related to anemia caused by a lack of B12, tachycardia, which is a rapid heartbeat, may appear, as the impaired red blood cells are unable to transport oxygen efficiently to all cells and tissues. To counteract this effect, the heart starts to beat faster, pumping more blood in order to make up for the lack of oxygen in these cells and tissues. As a consequence of B12 deficiency anemia, issues with concentration and attention span may arise. Those affected by this problem often find themselves becoming more easily distracted. Many people who are deficient in vitamin B12 may experience gastrointestinal symptoms such as nausea, constipation, and diarrhea. Additionally, some patients may experience a loss of taste and weight loss. A characteristic symptom of vitamin B12 deficiency is a so-called beefy tongue, a shiny and smooth tongue, due to inflammation and loss of papillae. In some cases, it may lead to ulcerations of the mouth and tongue, with accompanying pain. As I mentioned before, the consequence of a vitamin B12 deficiency is not only anemia. In my opinion, a much more serious problem is that in patients who do not provide an adequate level of B12 in their body, neurological changes may appear, which in some cases can even be irreversible. These problems stem from the fact that vitamin B12 is involved in the formation of the myelin sheath, which protects nerve cells from damage. When it is absent, it generally leads to disturbances in the functioning of the nervous system, resulting in a range of unpleasant and dangerous symptoms. Additionally, I will add an important piece of information that in some patients we are only dealing with neurological symptoms while there are no signs of anemia. Therefore, problems with the nervous system do not always go hand in hand with anemia, which I have already discussed. Due to peripheral neuropathy, a condition characterized by damage to the nerves, paresthesia may occur, which is a feeling of numbness, tingling, and burning in the limbs. Sometimes we may also experience pricking on the toe tips. This can even be the first neurological symptom of vitamin B12 deficiency. If the deficiency is allowed to worsen, additional signs may include disturbances of sensation and weakness of the legs and arms. Some B12 deficient patients also report reduced coordination of movement and instability of gait. A specific neurological symptom which is highly indicative of vitamin B12 deficiency in the body is the laryngitis sign. It occurs when there is a characteristic pain while bending the head forward or simply bending the neck. This symptom is often described by patients as a feeling of current passing along the spine. However, I must note that this symptom occurs quite rarely. When discussing the health consequences of nerve damage due to B12 deficiency, other ailments that can result include urinary incontinence, erectile dysfunction, and even deterioration of eyesight and hearing. It is also important to emphasize that mental decline, also known as secondary dementia, can occur in cases of vitamin B12 deficiency. Fortunately, once our bodies are replenished with B12, we have the chance to reverse this adverse effect. Other neurological symptoms include orthostatic hypotension, which is a sudden drop in blood pressure when changing body position from lying down to sitting or standing. As a consequence of this phenomenon, we can see the so-called stars in our visual field. As a deficiency of vitamin B12 develops, certain psychiatric symptoms may appear, such as mood disorders, anxiety, fear, depression, hallucinations, personality changes, or even the development of psychotic disorders. When it comes to vitamin B12 deficiency, I must mention another crucial issue. You should know that this vitamin is involved in certain biochemical processes in our body related to the transformation of homocysteine. Homocysteine is an amino acid that is a product of various chemical reactions in our body. It is important to note that when you lack vitamin B12, homocysteine accumulates in the blood, which can cause further health issues. This is caused by the fact that homocysteine has an atherogenic effect, meaning that it accelerates the formation of atherosclerotic changes in our arteries when it is present in excessive amounts. Moreover, it has prothrombotic properties, increasing the risk of clot formation in veins. Taking these facts into account, it can be said that one of the consequences of vitamin B12 deficiency is impaired circulation. I would like to pause for a moment and make a small request. If you find my videos helpful and would like to help this channel grow, please consider subscribing and if possible also clicking the bell icon next to it. That way you won't miss any valuable videos. Thank you and now let's get back to the topic. People with gastrointestinal disorders such as Crohn's disease, small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, celiac disease or infection with Helicobacter pylori, which is associated with inflammation of the stomach lining, may be particularly at risk of having a low vitamin B12 level. Similarly, people who had had portions of their stomach or small intestine removed are also predisposed to vitamin B12 deficiency. Lastly, people experiencing Addison-Birmer anemia, also known as pernicious anemia, are also prone to vitamin B12 deficiency. This is an autoimmune disease in which the gastric mucosal cells which produce a substance called Castle factor are damaged. I mention this because Castle factor binds to vitamin B12 in our digestive tract and allows it to be absorbed. Therefore, even if we are consuming B12 with our food, without Castle factor it cannot effectively enter the bloodstream and be used by our body. Vitamin B12 deficiency is also commonly observed among the elderly. There are several causes behind this condition, the most common being the vitamin B12 malabsorption syndrome. This is because elderly people often suffer from atrophic gastroenteritis. Furthermore, the older we get, the more often we experience a decrease in gastric acid, which only further hinders the release of vitamin B12 from food. It is important to emphasize that certain medications can cause vitamin B12 deficiency, such as proton pump inhibitors, for example omeprazole, and H2 receptors antagonists, for example ranitidine and famotidine, which are commonly used in the treatment of gastric and duodenal ulcers and in the relief of gastroesophageal reflux. Metformin, one of the most common treatments for diabetes, is also linked to B12 deficiency. Numerous research studies have shown that almost one-third of patients who have been taking metformin for a longer period of time may have B12 deficiency. It's possibly due to metformin interfering with the binding of vitamin B12 to the intrinsic factor, which is necessary for its absorption. Unfortunately, this problem is often overlooked. Why is this happening? As I mentioned before, in cases of vitamin B12 deficiency, not necessarily the hematological symptoms or those related to anemia will appear. Sometimes the main symptoms are neurological, stemming from neuropathy or nerve damage. What is key is that these types of ailments can also be caused by diabetes itself. We then talk about what is known as diabetic neuropathy. So we have the following situation. The patient with diabetes comes to the doctor taking metformin and complaining, for example, about tingling and numbness of their limbs or burning, stinging and pain in their feet. Then the doctor makes a wrong diagnosis, attributing these symptoms to insufficiently controlled diabetes. However, it might be that the symptoms are not related to diabetes itself, but to the metformin taken by patients with this disease. Therefore, if you have been taking this medicine for a long period, I encourage you to do a blood test to check your vitamin B12 level. When it comes to people at risk of vitamin B12 deficiency, vegans cannot be left out. This is because the main food sources of vitamin B12 are almost exclusively animal-based, such as red meat, fish, seafood, eggs, and dairy products. I will discuss what to eat to provide the right amounts of vitamin B12 later. Some single individuals who switch to a plant-based diet think they do not need to supplement with vitamin B12 as their intestines are populated with bacteria that produce the vitamin. While it is true that these helpful microorganisms do synthesize some amounts of vitamin B12, there is one key fact that is often forgotten. Production of B12 occurs in the large intestine, while absorption of vitamin B12 takes place in the small intestine. Therefore, it is impossible for produced B12 to travel back to the small intestine for absorption. This means that not much of the B12 produced by the intestines can be actually used. Other causes of low B12 levels include excessive alcohol consumption, long-term usage of oral contraceptives, chronic pancreatitis, and parasitic infections. If you have experienced any of those symptoms I recently mentioned or are a part of group at risk of vitamin B12 deficiency, I encourage you not to wait and get a blood test done to measure your B12 levels. The norms for B12 are somewhat controversial. Typically, a normal result is considered to be between 200 and 1300 picograms per milliliter or nanograms per liter. However, as I said, a hidden deficit can develop if the result lies in the range between 300 and 400 units. Based on the available data, I think a safe hormonal concentration of B12 should be at least 400 units, and optimally, one should strive for a level of 800 to 900 units. In addition to the underestimated norms, there's another problem with diagnosing vitamin B12 levels. What I mean is that the concentration of B12 in the blood does not fully reflect the saturation of the body with this vitamin. Therefore, if your result is around 300 to 400 picograms or below, a good solution is to do additional tests. I am referring to the measurement of homocysteine in the blood, which I have already mentioned, and whose concentration increases due to a lack of B12. It should be noted that an increased level of homocysteine does not always indicate a lack of B12. It is increasingly said that a so-called holotranscobalamin test should be carried out, meaning a simplified active form of vitamin B12. This test allows one to detect a deficiency of B12 at a quite early stage. Another quite sensitive indicator of B12 deficiency in tissues is the level of methylmalonic acid, which we can also check. Unfortunately, this test is rather expensive. Performing a blood morphology test will certainly be helpful as well. An increase in red blood cell volume, abbreviated as MCV, may indicate anemia due to a deficiency in B12. There may be a decrease in white blood cells, platelets, and neutrophilic granulocytes, as well as a decrease in hemoglobin concentration. Nevertheless, as I already mentioned, please remember that in the absence of B12, anemia may not always appear, so the blood morphology should only be treated as an additional factor. In order to provide our bodies with vitamin B12 and replenish possible deficiencies, we should first ensure that our diets are balanced. This means that foods such as organ meats, meaning beef or poultry liver, as well as poultry and beef, herring, rainbow trout, eggs and dairy products, such as natural yogurt or yellow and cottage cheeses, should be present on our tables often. Plant-based products do not contain significant amounts of vitamin B12, as they do not possess the ability to synthesize it. It is possible for some plants to contain bacteria which produce the vitamin, however, these bacteria are most likely capable of producing only minimal amounts due to B12 being non-stable. I would also like to mention that chlorella, a type of edible green-blue alga, can provide a certain amount of vitamin B12. Similarly, spirulina, a type of microalga, contains a certain type of pseudo-vitamin B12, which is structurally altered in comparison to regular B12 and as a result lacks its biological effect. Scientific societies have established a recommended daily intake of vitamin B12 of 2.4 micrograms. However, more and more experts are suggesting that this amount is too low and that it should be increased to around 6 to 10 micrograms per day. This demonstrates that certain aspects of B12 are underestimated and that it would be beneficial to change the current views of this vitamin. It is also worth noting that recommended amounts of nutrients, including vitamin B12, are directed at those who are healthy. When it comes to certain diseases, the nutrient requirements increase, something I can discuss another time. For individuals whose vitamin B12 levels are low, which is less than 350 picograms per milliliter of blood, it is recommended to take a supplement with 500 to 1000 micrograms daily until an optimal concentration is achieved in the blood. It is better to divide this daily dose into several smaller amounts to ensure that the vitamin is better absorbed. Meanwhile, if someone wishes to increase their level of B12 in their blood, an intake of 100 to 200 micrograms is sufficient. If you found this material interesting, I would be grateful if you could give it a thumbs up and leave a comment about which information I provided was the most interesting to you, or share your own experiences regarding B12. Taking the opportunity, I invite you to watch another video in which I discuss the signs of zinc deficiency, as this element's deficiency is also often overlooked. To watch the video, simply click the thumbnail that appeared on the screen. And that's all from me for today. Thank you for your attention, and I will see you next time.